Hello everyone, I'm going to start on a new dot art piece again, combined with resin. I already poured the first layer in my silicone mold of 6 inch, 15 centimeters, and I'm starting in the middle with a very large dot, and I'm using for this dot the primary elements from Color Art Sweet Lavender. And I mixed some DecoArt multi-surface silver in it to give it a little bit more sparkle. And what I'm doing now is adding a little bit more color to the dot. And I also mixed the primary elements in the Vivid Gloss Enamel that you also can buy at the shop of Color Art. And also a little bit of pouring medium, Vallejo pouring medium, to get it to the right consistency. Now I'm placing some small dots of the Art Alchemy Crocus Fields. And I'm starting again at 12, 3, 6 and 9 o'clock. And in between also these dots. And yeah, you need to make sure that the dots have all the same space between them. And the first layer of resin, I used the Stone Coat Art Coat, because that is heat resistant and also has a UV blocker. And I've used the Bling It Gold again on the outside. And the turquoise blue of Lures, also only on the outside, so the middle part will be again transparent. And the next color is again a primary element, the French lilac, and I mixed in this color some silver mica powder and also mixed it with the Vivid Gloss Enamel and a little bit of Vallejo pouring medium. All the materials I'm using are listed in the beginning of this video, but also in the description box with all the links where you can buy the materials. And also I've linked them in my Amazon Influences store, so if you want to see which colors, then you can check that out. Also again, I'm adding a kind of dotting tool some more color to the dots, and also to let it dome a little bit, because I like that. You can get some great depth with that. So we are a little bit further in the process. In between the smaller dots, a larger dot. Again, the Crocus Fields of Art Alchemy. And that I use straight out of the jar, nothing mixed with it. And again, the same color as I use for the larger center dot, the Sweet Lavender primary elements of Color Art with the DecoArt multi-surface silver. And at the end of the smaller dots, this larger one. The next color is the Royal Blue, also from Art Alchemy. And I'm using a marker again, because I don't have the right size dotting tool. I've ordered them, so, but yeah, in the meantime I'm using a marker. So on the edge, the Royal Blue. So I dip it in the paint and very gently I press it onto my resin. And all the way around the larger dot, the same color, the Royal Blue, But then very small dots. Yeah, I also speeded this video a little bit, but not that too much, because you need to see what I'm doing. Also the other side, some smaller dots. Yeah, we are a little bit further in the process, because on the other dots I also put around the smaller ones. And now I'm using the rich turquoise, also from Art Alchemy. And again, all the way around the larger one, the smaller dots. Very nice sparkly color. And the next color, that's from Deco Art Americana, the Bahama Blue. And if you make a mistake, you can wipe the dot away and place a new one. Also on the other side. Yeah, and also for this piece, the center will be transparent, and on the outside the turquoise color with the blinged gold. Now again I'm working on the middle part with some smaller crocus field dots, the purple color. Also at the end of this video a close-up, then you can see the dots up close and the sparkle. Again, I'm using the French lilac, the primary elements, because I want to have a point. That's why I'm placing these three dots. And all the way around the larger one, I'm using again the crocus fields, but then a smaller dot, and I work them out. So you dip your dotting tool in the paint one time and you walk it all the way around so that the dots get smaller. There you can see it. Also on the other side. and some very small dots around the French lilac dot. Yeah, and all the layers in between will be the quick coat of stone coat because that dries very fast. But the front and the back will be the hard coat because that is UV resistant and the quick coat doesn't have a UV block in it. But if I use a quick coat, then I can work much faster. Again, the Bahama Blues of Deco Art. Little bit further in the process. Again, the rich turquoise from Art Alchemy. And the next color, that's the petal pink, also from Deco Art Americana. Very small dots. And also the Deco Art, you don't have to mix with anything. It has the right consistency. So you can use it straight out of the bottle. Now a larger dot on the end of the smaller ones. And again, I'm using the Bahama Blue of Deco Art. Again, a little bit further in the process, and I'm now using a very small dotting tool, and all the way around the larger one, these smaller dots, and again I'm working them out to get the dots smaller at the end. There you can see it. Next color, again the rich turquoise, also all the way around the larger dot, and I'm going to do the same as I did with the Bahama Blue. Again, I'm walking the dot out. next color is the royal blue, and I do the same again. And also on the other side, there you can see it. Again, I'm using the petal pink of DecoArt. Also very small dots all the way around the crocus fields, the purple dot. And also for this design, I made it first on a piece of Hupo paper because, to also practice a little bit, but also to see if the design is okay. And then I mark the center dots on my resin, and the rest is all freehand. Normally, you would draw lines on your canvas or MDF board, but yeah, you can't do that with the resin, so it's all freehand. So I'm almost done with the first layer, with the dots for the first layer, and then I need to let this dry, this paint, and then I can add a second layer of resin. But now we can go to the close-up of the first layer. So this is how it looks up close, and I like the design. I like the colors together. They are very sparkly, especially the primary elements of color art. But I also like the Bahama blues. That's the blue color, the light blue color. Yeah, it's not perfect, but yeah, it's all freehand, and. I'm pleased what I have so far. So for the next layer, I hope to create some depth with the next dots I place on top of these. But first I need to let it dry. There you can see the very small dots I placed on the resin. So if you like what I'm doing, please subscribe to my channel. Give me a thumbs up for this video. If you have tips, comments or questions, place them under the video or send me an email. All the links of the materials I've used are listed in the description box, and also you can find them in my Influencers Amazon store, so you can also check that out. And I want to thank you all for watching, and I will see you in the next video. Bye!